Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know what? It's a good day.
Yes, it is.
It's a good day. Can I, Ed, you want to come out here for a minute? Can I get a couple of guys up here? A couple of spirit-filled men that would like to lay hands on this handsome gentleman. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father God, I lift up this offering before you right now, but Lord, it's something that you've provided in order for us to be able to give. But Lord, more importantly, Each and every one of us is an offering, Lord God. Lord, we want to offer ourselves before you today, Father God. And Lord, we have a brother here that you're quite aware of his condition, Lord God. And Lord, oh God, our hope is in you, Lord God. Lord, doctors can only do so much, Lord God. We place all of our trust in you, Father. And Lord, we're just thankful that you tugged on his heart today and brought him in into our presence, giving us the opportunity to lay hands on him and just impart that you've put into each and every one of us, Father God. Lord, there's a Holy Spirit working in each one of us, Father God, that can do works that are mightier than we can even imagine right now. So, Lord, we impart. We impart, Father God. Hallelujah. Strengthen this man. Strengthen that, Father God, Lord. And where the medicine is failing, Lord, we know that you're greater than the medicine, Lord God. You can go well beyond what the doctors can do. And, Lord, we thank you for doctors, Lord. But we're especially thankful for you and the knowledge that you've placed within each one of us to have the knowledge to call on your name, Lord God, when we find ourselves in a time of need. Oh, mighty God, we just thank you today, Father God. Lord, it's a good day. It's a good day. Lord, let this good day go down in Ed's mind, Lord, the day after the 4th of July, the fifth day, and Lord, they told him that there was only five medications that they could give him. There was nothing else they can do. And this is the fifth. Hallelujah. Oh, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God.
From the throne.
Minister to him, Father God, right now. Each and every cell, Lord, you created it. You probably named every one of the cells within our bodies, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All of our hope is in you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
My Savior God, joy shall fill my heart, then I shall bow with humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul,
Jesus, mighty God, marvelous, great and mighty King, hallelujah, Jesus. We exalt your holy and righteous name, Jesus. Worthy are you, Lord Jesus.
To the mountains, I see your face. When I look into the night sky, it sparkles your name. The wind and the clouds and the blue in the sky, the sun and the moon and the stars so high, that's what draws me.
How they grow and the trees.
What you pray, I'll pray. 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 Where you go, I'll go. What you say, I'll say. What you pray, I'll pray. What you pray, I'll pray. Where you go, I'll go. What you say, I'll say. What you pray, I'll pray. What you pray, I'll pray.
I will run, I will run, I
run, I will 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 run the race. I will run, I will run, I will run the race. We will run, we will run, we will run.
Every room of our hearts, Lord, come consume.
set before us.
We will see
your face as the prize of our lives.
We will run.
Yes, Jesus, we will run. 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 We will run.
What I heard. I'll stand right here. He'll consume it. He'll consume every part of us. But the bottom line is we are kings and priests. We have to bring it and lay it on the altar.
That's it.
Simple as that. If you don't lay it, he won't consume it. And we'll just keep going around the same cycle.
Yeah.
Fran said this because the Lord spoke to her and said to her, it's not those who start out in the race, but it's those who finish the race. Each one of us here has a choice to finish the race. We can lay back or we can do what the Lord said, finish the race.
Yeah, this is a race, but it's not a sprint, and we all know that. This is more like a marathon. It's a lifelong journey. That's what it is. Let's put it this way. You can't outrun God because he goes before you.
And he goes behind you.
That's right.
quit. This race without you, and you can't win this race without me. It's the way God has set it up. It's a safety net for all of us. Like Stephen said, we must all lay it at the altar.
For something that you can't receive, you won't receive it. And so if we corporately ask, we're asking for him to corporately give. I know there's all of us in here, we don't want church as usual anymore. We want the Holy Spirit, which we know is here. We know he's here. So when we say come, we're looking right at him. But we're saying, God, come give us new revelation in you. Come, Holy Spirit, and rise up within each every one of us. Come, come. Yes. It's okay to ask him to come even though he's right here.
That's right. That's right.
Because what you're asking for is you're asking for him to develop within each and every one of us, in this house, in us. We're asking him to develop himself in us. to develop himself in us. And so when we say we will run the race, it's a declaration, it's a declaring. And you know, sometimes we're like, why do we sing these songs over and over again? And I heard another worship leader say this before. We repeat songs over and over again. There's only one song they sing, right? That's what the Bible says. There's only one song they sing. Yep. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. We can't get tired when we get to these points where we're repeating a song over and over again. This is the time where you have to press in. You have to press. If we don't press as a body, as a congregation, we're going to keep going around the same mountain. We want to have a supernatural experience. And it's not about any person up here. It's not about any one person out there. No. It's about all of us together.
Right. Together.
Because some of the most beautiful moments in song service in here are when you guys take over the service. Yeah. And we just play along. And it's no pressure on any one person. It's just us coming together as a body and declaring, we will run. We will run, Lord. We will run. Consume our hearts, Lord. Let us go deeper and deeper and deeper into what you have for each and every person in this room. Let us pour into one another, vessel to vessel to vessel. Holy Spirit, rise up within us. Come in a new way. Come in a new way in every single person. It's a cry. It comes up and out, and it's deep, and we need to have it, and it's passion. It's passion to follow him. It's passion to love him. It's a passion that says, change us, Lord. Do something different within us, Lord. Help us. Help us, Lord God. Help us to have more of you working in our everyday lives, Lord God. Lord, we're asking. We're asking, Lord God. Lord, come in a new way in this house, Lord God. Come in a new way, Lord God. In a way we've never experienced you before, Lord God. Lord, we throw in all the hay, the wood, and the stubble. We throw in all the hay, the wood, and the stubble. We throw in all the things that stop us from going forth in you. We throw it all in, we throw it all in, we throw in the hay, the wood, and the stubble. We throw in the hay, the wood, and the stubble. We throw in all the things that stop us from having more of you. Set us ablaze, Lord. Set us ablaze.
Yes, Lord.
Set us ablaze, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Set us ablaze. Set me ablaze, set me ablaze, till you're all that I know. Set us ablaze, set us ablaze, till you're all that we know. Set us ablaze, set us ablaze, till you're all that we know. Oh.
There's a change in our hearts, Lord, when you move. There's a change in our hearts, Lord, when you move. There's a change in our hearts,
thing about the race. He's the one that set it forth. And then he invited you to run.
Thank you, Lord.
And his word declares that you run it as if it's going to happen in your day, whether it does or it doesn't. Because in the end, the prize is already set because it's Him. That's cool. That's cool. That gives you a hope that you don't have to worry about anything. All your responsibility is the run. And you run it with those that God has set you with. You run it as the corporate one, as the son. You run the race. Because like you said, He has a place already prepared. Amen? I love it. Love you. Bless you.